Welcome back, English Movers 2. I'm Teacher Nick. I hope you're very excited for going back to school next week and seeing all of your friends and teachers once more. Now, moving on to the lesson, we're going to start with a quick video warm-up.
I'll go, I know, everybody on this island seems so happy on this island. Everything is by design. I know everybody on this island has a role on this island, so maybe I can roll with mine. I can lead with pride, I can make us strong. I'll be satisfied if I play along, but the voice inside sings a different song. What is wrong with me? See the light as it shines on the sea. Deep it goes, and it seems like it's calling out to me. So come find me and let me know what's beyond that line. Will I cross that line? The line with the sky with the sea. It calls me, and no one knows how far it goes. If the wind in my sail on the sea stays behind.
Guys, I hope you enjoyed that video. Now, today's lesson is Unit 3, Reading 3, John Henry and the Machine. The reading strategy is to identify characters, and this is on pages 174 to 175 in your cornerstones. Now, what is a tall tale? A tall tale is a story that may or may not be true, but that contains details that are hard to believe. So a tall tale is a story, it could be true, it could not be true, but something in the story is very difficult for you to believe. It seems unrealistic, okay? Describe what you can see happening in this picture. So who is this? It's a picture from your textbook. Good, it's a young John Henry, or a baby John Henry. Now, what's he doing? What's this in his hands? Can you remember? Good, it's a sledgehammer. And what's he doing with the sledgehammer? He's lifting it up above his head. Very good. A baby John Henry is lifting a sledgehammer over his head. Now, can a baby lift a sledgehammer over the head? Look, this person here, he's holding a sledgehammer and using it, but he's very big and strong, isn't he? Do you think this baby, very small baby, could lift a sledgehammer over their head? No. So that is an example of why John Henry and the Machine is a tall tale. Because John Henry can lift a sledgehammer over his head when he's a baby. And it's not believable for a baby to be able to do that. Now, the reading strategy, identify characters. So identify means we find and we name the characters, okay? And we can see what the reason for them being in the story is, okay? Characters are the people or animals in a story or poem. So who are these people in this picture? Who are these characters? It's Harry Potter, Ron Weasley, and Hermione from the Harry Potter book and movie series. And what about these animals? Do you recognize this story? It's the three little pigs and the wolf. Okay, so just remember, characters can be either people or animals in a story or poem. Now, not all characters are the same. The main characters are the most important ones. Okay, can you say main characters? The minor characters are less important. Who are the characters in Cinderella? Now, before we look at the picture, see if you can think of any of the characters that you know from the popular story Cinderella. Good, so these are all of, not all of the characters, these are some of the characters from Cinderella. You can see Cinderella here, Prince Charming, and many others. There are two main characters in Cinderella. Who are they? First one. You can always, especially with fairy tales, you can always find out one of the main characters because they're normally in the name of the story. Cinderella. So Cinderella is one main character. And who does she have a lot of trouble with in the story? Who is the other main character? Who's this? It's Cinderella's stepmother. So Cinderella and Cinderella's stepmother, they are the two main characters in the story Cinderella. The rest of the characters are the minor characters. So all of these characters, including Prince Charming, are minor characters. They're less important than the main characters, Cinderella and Cinderella's stepmother. Now, before we go on to the reading, our reading skill. As you read, use the pictures to help you understand the words and ideas. Okay, so whenever you're reading and there are pictures that go alongside the reading, make sure you look at them while you're reading, okay? Guided reading, so page 174. I will read and then you can repeat after me, okay? The world is full of stories about the mighty John Henry. Can you remember, what does mighty mean? Mighty means big and strong. Now repeat after me. The world is full of stories about the mighty John Henry. So this picture here is showing you in real life a tribute on a statue of John Henry, because there's so many stories about him, they've made a statue for him, many statues I think actually in America. But he started out as a baby just like the rest of us. We all start our lives as babies. This is normal, isn't it? John Henry's no different. He was also a baby just like you and me. Now repeat after me. But he started out as a baby just like the rest of us. The only difference was that even as a baby, John Henry could lift a sledgehammer over his head. John Henry is just the same as you and me. He was also a baby, but the only thing that was different about him was he was very strong. He could lift a sledgehammer over his head as a baby. I couldn't lift a sledgehammer over my head as a baby, and I'm sure you couldn't either. It's not very believable, is it? Now repeat after me. The only difference was that even as a baby, John Henry could lift a sledgehammer over his head. Young John Henry loved that big hammer. He liked to pound on rocks. Now repeat the sentence after me. Young John Henry loved that big hammer. He liked to pound on rocks. When you pound something, you hit it very hard. Repeat after me. Pound. Pound. And an example. This boxer likes to pound the punch bag. So when the boxer hits the punch bag very hard, he is pounding it. Up went the hammer, and then down it came. John Henry could turn big rocks into dust. Repeat after me. Up went the hammer, and then down it came. John Henry could turn big rocks into dust. So here you can see the big rocks, and after he pounds them with the hammer, he turns them into dust. When he grew up, John Henry worked for the railroad. Repeat after me. When he grew up, John Henry worked for the railroad. Railroad. He was bigger and stronger than everybody else on the job. So in the picture you can see a very big and strong person and a much smaller person. This big and strong person was John Henry at work. Now repeat after me. He was bigger and stronger than everybody else on the job. All day long, he hammered steel spikes into rocks. So these, can you say, spikes? Spikes. These are the steel spikes. So you get the hammer and you put the spike end down into the rock and you hammer down and it makes the rock break more easily. Now repeat after me. All day long he hammered steel spikes into rocks. Very good. He broke every rock that was in the way of the railroad. So, you can see here there's a rock that's in the way of the railroad. John Henry's job was to get his big sledgehammer, his steel spike, and pound the rocks into dust so that they could continue to work on the railroad. Now repeat after me. He broke every rock that was in the way of the railroad. John Henry was as happy as a man could be. So John Henry was very happy doing his job. He loved to pound rocks into dust with a sledgehammer. Now repeat after me. John Henry was as happy as a man could be. Then a stranger brought a new machine to town. So here is a stranger. A stranger is somebody that we don't know. And this is the machine that he brought to town. And this is John Henry with his sledgehammer. Now, repeat after me. Then a stranger brought a new machine to town. So somebody that nobody in the town knows brings a special new machine. And what's that machine going to do? I'm not sure. Now, that's all the reading that we're going to do for today, but we're going to do a quick review quiz to see how much as you've managed to understand, okay? Can an animal be a character in a poem or story? So this question is yes or no. Can an animal be a character in a poem or a story? What about the three little pigs? or Little Red Riding Hood? Yes, they can. So this story is Little Red Riding Hood. And one of the characters is the wolf. And the wolf is an animal. So yes, animals can be characters in stories. In Cinderella, is Prince Charming a main character or a minor character? Can you remember how many main characters are there in Cinderella? It's two, aren't there? And you can remember one of the main characters is Cinderella. Good. Now, is Prince Charming the other main character or is he a minor character? Prince Charming, he is a minor character. So Prince Charming is less important to the story than Cinderella and her stepmother. What does pound mean? To hit very softly or to hit very hard? We can remember that the boxer likes to pound a punch bag. Now, boxers, do they want to hit very softly or do they want to hit very hard? Very good. So pound means to hit very hard. You can even, if you've been doing a lot of studying, you could say I was pounding my studying. I was studying very hard. All day long, John Henry hammered steel something into rocks. Can you remember what these things are called that John Henry hammered into rocks? Spikes into rocks. Repeat after me. All day long, John Henry hammered steel spikes into rocks. Good job. Now, the final question. Who brought a new machine to town? John Henry or the stranger? Did John Henry bring the new machine to town? I don't think so. I think John Henry was happy pounding rocks into dust with his sledgehammer and steel spikes. So that means the stranger brought the new machine to town. Good. Okay, so that's the end of class today, guys. Thank you very much. I'm really looking forward to seeing you all next week offline in the classroom, and I hope you've enjoyed these videos and they've been helpful for your studies. Now your homework is to reread pages 174 and 175 and to do your set homework. Thanks very much. Look forward to seeing you next week. Goodbye.